You stand the tallest when you're on your knees, amen?
Amen.
Because they were in touch with the living God. And some of the Chaldeans said to the king, O king, live forever. There is no king who can live forever except the King of Kings, amen?
That's right.
And the God of Gods. Amen. Have you not made a decree that all shall bow and worship? There are three Hebrew boys. They call them by the Babylonian names, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. But I like the Hebrew names, Hananiah, Mishael, and Azariah, amen?
Yes.
He said, these boys did not bow. And the king said to these men, now I have given you a good education in the University of Babylon. I have given you a plush, pleasure apartment overlooking the city. You have good jobs. I have elected you to a high position. I have given you royal garments to wear. I have given you choice shoes. You are not like the ordinary wise men. You are in a good position. I have increased your salary. Could you not just do this for me? Because I have always looking at you are making me look bad. Could you not just bow down and worship? A tough assignment. And they said, oh king, we are careful to answer you in this matter. You see, the God we serve is able to deliver us. You see, Nebuchadnezzar has put his God almost 10 story high, and in his mind, his God was the highest God up to that point in time. Amen? Could you not just do this for me? And they said to the king, we are not careful. We will not bow, even if you give us another chance. Be it known unto you that the God we serve is able to deliver us. But if not, we still are not going to bow. Nebuchadnezzar got hot. He was enraged, the Bible says. He got mad. That was a land that was filled with oil and pitch and asphalt. They could extract chemicals that would be hotter than a normal fire. So he commanded to heat the furnace 7 times hotter. And the Bible says that they were born in the hoses that they stuck in the socks, in the hats, in the clothes. And they were tied. They were born. And they were thrown in the fiery furnace. Friend of mine, I want you to know that there was something going on in heaven. I could imagine Gabriel saying to the father, look, your children is about to be thrown into the fire. Shall I go down in the fiery furnace and bring an air conditioned unit? Shall I go down? And while Gabriel was speaking to God the Father, there was a voice heard from the furnace way down there. Father, I am already here. Some people say that my God is slow. But I want you to know that my God is not slow. He may not come when you want it, but he's always on time. He's an on-time God.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
He always shows up on time. They had a tough assignment, to bow or not to bow. When they were thrown in the furnace, Nebuchadnezzar said, look, look, behold, did we not throw 3 men? I see 4, and the form of the 4th is like the Son of God. Now how did he know who the Son of God looked like? Because in Daniel chapter 2, he had a dream, and he saw a stone cut out without hands, and the stone smote the image, and ground it to powder. Nebuchadnezzar was saying, I saw him before, look, he's there. And the form of the fourth is like the Son of God. When you pass through the fire, I will be with you.
Yes.
When you pass through the flood, I will be with you. Amen.
Yes.
No, friend of mine. Nebuchadnezzar said, you servants of the Most High God. Now, according to Nebuchadnezzar, his God at that point in time was the highest God. But your God is higher than my God. Ye servants of the Most High God, come out and come here. I'm not going to go where you are. You're going to come out and come here. Friend of mine, they had a tough assignment. This world is about to end up in cataclysmic suddenness. There's going to be a time of trouble such as never was. Every soul will be tested and tried as though there is not another upon the face of this earth. When the rubber meets the road, you and I are going to find out what kind of material we're made of. These stories are not just absurd words. God told Jeremiah, in Jeremiah chapter 5. Let's look at it. Jeremiah chapter 5. Where's our scripture reading, brother? Comes again, we're gonna swing by those pearly gates and those glittering hinges. We're going to walk on the streets of gold. We're going to stand on a sea of glass. We're going to sit at a welcome table. And John says in Revelation chapter 22, and he showed me a pure river of water of life, clear as crystal, proceeding after the throne of God. In the midst of the street of it, on every side of the river, was there a tree of life, which bare 12 man of mangoes. Amen. No, it says 12 man of fruits, but it was 12 man of mangoes.
Okay.
And every man that yielded his fruit every month, amen. It's going to be all right, friend of mine. We're going to sit at the welcome table. We're going to drink from the water of life. We're going to eat from the tree of life.
Praise
it's going to be all right one of these days, friend of mine. Soon and very soon, we're going to see the King.
Yes.
It's a tough assignment. But God is with us, amen?
Yes.
I want to be that number where the saints go marching in, amen?
Amen.
Will you be there, friend of mine? Amen. We got to tell somebody about Jesus' love and it's soon coming. What a day that will be. It is said about that when the children of Israel crossed over the Red Sea, they sang the first stanza. But when we get over yonder, we're going to sing the second stanza, amen?
Hallelujah.
And angels are going to fold their wings because they cannot hear about redemption story. They don't know what it's like to be hungry and tired and thirsty. They don't know what it's like to be in sin and suffer pain. But we can tell of the love of Jesus. The hymn writer says, I was sinking deep in sin, sinking deeply, standing, sinking to rise no more, but the word but is a conjunctive injunction. It changes that which has gone before from that which is to come.
Yes.
The wages of sin is death, but yes. The gift of God is eternal life.
Yes.
Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
What a day it's going to be, amen?
Amen.
I know what Jesus has done for me. He has called me from sin. He has taken me from the gutter, from a life of sin. And he has planted my feet on higher ground. He sent the Holy Spirit in and took the smell out of the house. And I'm a new creature in Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
I'm not what I used to be. I'm not what I should be by the grace of God. Every day with Jesus is sweeter than the day before. Amen.
Amen.
He's coming again. Amen. There might be somebody here, you want to make a decision for Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
It's not time to be playing church.
Amen.
It's time to be in business with Jesus. Amen. Amen. There might be somebody here. You want to make that decision. You want to put your hands in the hands of Jesus. To make your calling and election sure. You have not surrendered totally. Maybe there might be somebody here. You have not been baptized by immersion. You want to make that decision for Jesus. Friend of mine, I want to open the doors of the church. You can make this decision for Jesus, friend of mine, before it is eternally too late. Jesus is calling, friend of mine. Why don't you let him come in? Softly and tenderly. Let's sing that. Softly and tenderly. Jesus is calling. He's calling. Oh, sinner, will you come home? As we sing this hymn before the closing hymn, why not contemplate on the words of the same? In the quietness of the moment, it's between you and the Lord, amen? Make a commitment. There might be somebody here in Bible studies. You need to know more about Jesus and his